Wow, Walter Hamada is having a very good day. I can't believe it. He has gone from taking a very impressive chance, I think a very good gamble, on a newcomer to lassoing one of the most experienced directors of all time. That's right, you saw the thumbnail for this video correctly. It's actually Steven freaking Spielberg. I can't believe it, he's joining the DCEU! But I guess to minimize the risk, Spielberg is going to direct the World War II actioner comic Blackhawk. It's hard to say it because it's like, yay, aw, you know, that's like the mix of emotions. But I have a loophole here. We'll see if Spielberg flies through it. But anyway, this is an old comic about a squadron of fighter pilots. I'm sure you've seen it if you're a DC fan. It's always been a little bit on the edges even today. We'll talk about Lady Blackhawk, the one character who's stuck around. I'm sure some of you, I saw a number of you being like, why is DC pushing all these female characters and directors? We want Man of Steel too, damn it. And I feel your pain. I understand it. I hope they keep it balanced. And you'll be happy to know that the Blackhawks is pretty much a team of all men. But yes, Lady Blackhawk, I'm sure, is going to be the entry point for many of you. But anyway, the press release from DC itself is very optimistic here, saying that this is Spielberg's first, their words, not mine, first feature centered around characters from the DC universe. So you're like, how are the Blackhawks going to stick around? I don't know. Maybe they'll show up in the Green Lantern movie they're thinking of making, because it is a group of fighter pilots. Makes sense that call sign would have a legacy and be continued. I'm very curious as to how this is going to play into the DCEU, and I do have my own theories. The Justice Society of America. We'll get there. But first, I would have to say that Spielberg must have really enjoyed his Warner Brothers experience making Ready Player One, right? That he would re-up not only with the studio, because, you know, Amblin has a first look deal over at Universal, his production company that he's really trying to reinvigorate. So he's sticking with Warner Brothers here and also joining their beleaguered franchise. I mean, talk about doing the studio a solid, right? And I know Spielberg might think he's Teflon, but I mean, his box office has been okay, and you know, nobody appreciates his recent Netflix comments. So I don't think he is Teflon. I mean, just look at the backlash to Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, right? He doesn't need another one of those. Could he survive another one of those? He could, he's Spielberg. But still, I don't think he's Teflon. But anyway, not only is he, I think this is to help Warner Brothers and to deepen his relationship with the studio, but this is for Amblin. Amblin Entertainment will be involved. That's, again, his production company. It's been around forever. But as we've recently discussed, he's really trying to get it back up and running aggressively. And he has a number of projects that he's working on through this production company, through this shingle. And this is really low risk for Steven Spielberg, right? I mean, it's got shades of both Indiana Jones, and by the way, David Koepp is scripting. He's written some good ones for Spielberg, so even though Koepp's track record is also shaky, I feel good about this. And it's also even a little Tintin, as Blackhawk and his team, the Blackhawks, named after him. He must be quite a swell guy for that to happen. But they often found themselves in fantastic situations fighting fantastic creatures. Think about the opening sequence for Kong Skull Island. The best part of the movie, by the way. I thought very ambitious, and I almost would have liked the movie to have stayed in that time period. Good stuff. So if they can go in that direction, and that was very much modeled after Spielberg anyway, I think we'd all be very happy. So anyway, World War I also proved to be a spectacular setting for the DCEU with Wonder Woman. So they're obviously eager to dive back into the history books, not only with Wonder Woman 2, but also now this Blackhawk movie. Now, speaking of Wonder Woman, she can obviously appear in this movie because she came to man's world during World War I. And she would be the only current modern DCEU superhero who can guest in this movie. But otherwise, yes, the Justice Society of America could either guest or outrightly debut here. And I think fans would go crazy about this. I think this is a very good idea. They're basically the first version of the Justice League. It would have kind of like a Watchmen vibe. You know, with the earlier version of the team, you know, the movie touched on that. The comic did it spectacularly. And I think that could be really interesting and sophisticated. I would love that. I don't know if Spielberg's going to be that ambitious. I wish that he would be. I think it would be huge boon to this film. You might think, then why not just make a Justice Society of America movie? I don't know. I don't know what's going on with the entry points of the DCEU here, but I still think this is exciting. So just for those of you who aren't familiar, the Justice Society of America was an early version of the Justice League. And sure enough, it had early versions of The Flash, Green Lantern, and Black Canary even. And I'm sure you're familiar with all of those to some degree, even if you're the most casual DC fan. Also, they have fan favorites on the team like Dr. Fate. What a way to introduce Dr. Fate. Hawkman, Mr. Terrific, and more. And I think that even just one or two of those would be fantastic and really help out this movie. As for diversity on the Blackhawk team itself, it had a Chinese cook who also ended up knowing martial arts and was Blackhawk's sidekick. But it was bad. It was really bad. It was like Mickey Rooney in Breakfast at Tiffany's bad. And that's going to haunt this movie. So they're going to have to work very hard to combat that, right? But otherwise, not a lot of ethnic diversity, but I'm sure that's something that will be also be recalibrated. And then they did have that one female member of the team, Lady Blackhawk, one of the most popular characters to come out of the comic book. And she even popped up in the New 52 in, wait for it, The Birds of Prey, which is another movie they're making, right? So don't be surprised if maybe Lady Blackhawk is on that roster. This sounds super confusing to non-comic book fans, but we're going with it. So Spielberg is said to be making Indy 5 first and also his West Side Story remake, but his schedule often changes as to, you know, whatever is gelling faster he gets the most excited about. He's Steven Spielberg. He can do whatever he wants. And apparently, join the DCEU is what he wants to do. What a vote of confidence for Walter Hamada and the franchise at large. That's as valuable as whatever movie he might make for them. How exciting. I think it could be really, really cool. Spielberg is one of my favorite filmmakers. He is a master filmmaker. I think he's not quite as good as he once was. But I feel he can get back there. And it's a major feather in Walter Hamada's cap to have secured a filmmaker of this caliber. That's very exciting. Maybe now he can use this to coax Scorsese out of just being a producer on that Joker origin movie. Well, Todd Phillips is directing, but I'd be like, hey, Scorsese, you want to become maybe a little more involved? Who knows if maybe Scorsese was the carrot for Spielberg? Either way, very, very exciting development. So what do you think? And do you think the JSA should appear in this movie, and in what capacity? How about Wonder Woman? Do you think it needs superheroes? I think it definitely needs superheroes if it's going to be... Otherwise, we're going to be like, it's not part of the DCEU. It's its own movie. What are you trying to do here? But we'll see. But Spielberg making a comic book movie? I don't care what it is. I'm very, very excited. Share your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.